This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. In this video, we're going to show how to prove an equation is not an identity. So first of all, to prove an equation is an identity, you would have to show that each side of the equation would equal the same number for every value of the variable. That's tricky when it comes to something like a trig equation, but for some algebra equations, this isn't too difficult. And we'll do one of those in a minute. But to prove that an equation is not an identity, all you need to do is show that for at least one value you plug in for the variable, the two sides do not equal the same number. So that's usually easier if you're sure something's not an identity, to just try one number and then prove that it can't be an identity because you get a different thing on each side. So for instance, this is a basic algebra problem, and how could we show that this is an identity? So here's my equation, 5 plus 3x minus 2, and the question is, does that always equal 3x minus 1? Well, if we simplify this left-hand side, we would have to distribute the 3, right? So we would get 5 plus 3x minus 6, and then I would combine like terms, and we get 3x minus 1. So basically, you could say, well, is this equal right here? And you could see yes. So you could say, yes, it's an identity because both sides simplify to 3x minus 1. Or what you could do is simplify this a little bit further. So let's say now you're trying to solve the equation. How would you try to solve this equation? Well, if you subtracted 3x from both sides and you added 1 to both sides, for instance, you get a true equation. So that's another way some people show that you have an identity, is if you try to solve it, you just get something that is always true no matter what. But in any case, we would then say this is an identity because they both simplify, both sides simplify to 3x minus 1. That would be a way of showing that. What we're going to focus on is how to prove something is not an identity. So here's a problem. Prove that x plus 2 quantity squared equals x squared plus 4 is not an identity. A lot of people think this is true, that x plus 2 squared actually does equal x squared plus 4. So here's how we do it. We're just going to pick a number, and you might pick a number and it might look that this is true, but remember, you can't, to prove something's an identity, you'd have to try every value of x in the world, which is impossible. So instead, let's just try something. So let's try x equals, all right, pick any number you want. How about you pick 3? All right, so what we're going to do that is we're going to do, see what happens when we plug 3 on the left side of the equation and see what it equals. So on the left side, I'll call this left side of equation. If I'm going to plug in 3 for x, then I would get 3 plus 2 squared, which is equal to 5 squared. Using my order of operations, you do inside parentheses first, and that would equal to 25. Now let's see what happens to the right side when I plug in x equals 3. So I'm plugging in 3 for x, squaring it, plus 4. 3 squared is 9. 9 plus 4 is 13. So I have just shown that if I plug in 3 for x, I don't get the same number on each side. So this is how we'd write our answer. Since the values of x plus 2 squared and x squared plus 4, right, that was the two sides of the equation, are unequal for x equals 3, so I found a value for which they were unequal, the equation is not an identity. All you have to do is show that it's not true for one value. Now, by the way, if you'd plugged in 0 for x, you might think, oh, look at, I got 4 no matter what. You know, if you put in 0 for x, on the left you'll get 2 squared, and on the right you'll get 0 plus 4. You're going to get that they're equal. So that would not help us prove it's not an identity. But it doesn't prove it's true unless it works for every single number. So if it doesn't work for one value, try another value. All right, so here's a trig equation. We want to show that the tangent squared x minus 1 equals secant squared x is not an identity. So we're going to try to put in a value for x and show that the left-hand side is not the same as the right-hand side. Now, here's a little trick I do. If I can, I choose 0 for x, but you have to be careful that it would be defined. So if when you plug in 0, it's not defined, you can't do it. You could choose 30 degrees, you could choose 45 degrees, but for instance, you couldn't choose pi over 2 because the tangent of pi over 2 is not defined. So how about, let's see what happens if I do plug in 0. So I'm going to try it, because I know that the tangent and secant are both defined at x equals 0. So I'm going to plug in x equals 0, and so I'm going to do my left-hand side. I'm just going to now put LHS instead of LS, sorry, for left-hand side. So my left-hand side, I'd have the tangent squared 0 minus 1. So that means the tangent of 0, right? That's really the tangent of 0 squared, right? Minus 1. Which is, all right, what's the tangent of 0? So here's how I do it. Some of you may memorize it. I just think of this ordered pair on the unit circle. And I remember tangent is y over x. So that gives me 0. So the tangent of 0 ends up being 0. So I have 0 squared minus 1, which equals negative 1. All right, how about the right-hand side? I have secant squared. Secant squared of 0. All right, so what is that? Well, the secant is the reciprocal of the cosine. The cosine is 1, right? At 0, cosine of 0 is just 1. It's the x-coordinate. So the reciprocal of 1 is still 1. So this would be 1 squared, and 1 squared is 1. So notice the left-hand side, when I plugged in x equals 0, was negative 1, but the right-hand side was 1. So I did not get the same thing when I chose to put in x equals 0. So this would be our answer. Since the values of the tangent squared x minus 1 and secant squared x are unequal for x equals 0, the equation is not an identity. You always have to show what you would get when you plugged in the x equals 0. So the work has to be shown up here so it's clear that you did get different values. Let's do the same problem using a different value for x, because somebody else might have thought of putting in pi over 4 for x, for instance. So let's do that. Left-hand side. Left-hand side is the tan squared x minus 1. So we're putting tan squared pi over 4 minus 1. Now remember, for pi over 4, this is pi over 4. We could put 1, 1 squared of 2. So the tangent is the opposite over adjacent, if you want to think of that, or the y over the x. We have 1. So this is the same thing as the tangent of pi over 4 squared, right, minus 1. And the tangent of pi over 4 is 1. So we have 1 squared minus 1, which is 1 minus 1, which is 0. So when you plug in pi over 4 for x, the left-hand side simplifies to 0. What about the right-hand side? The right-hand side is secant squared x. So I'm putting in secant squared pi over 4. And remember what that means. That means the secant of pi over 4, right, squared. All right, what's the secant? That would be the r over x. So it's square root of 2 over 1. So this is square root of 2, right? Square root of 2 over 1 is just square root of 2. And square root of 2 squared is 2. So when I plugged in pi over 4, I also show that the left-hand side and the right-hand side give me different numbers. So you can see there's, you know, infinitely many different possibilities you might plug in for x, but you only have to show it for one value of x to prove that it's not an identity. So again, we've shown it, and then we state this in as a sentence. Since the values of the tangent squared x minus 1 and secant squared x are unequal for, not x equals 0, but pi over 4, I have to say what I've shown. I've shown that when you plug in x equals pi over 4, that you get different values on each time. So the equation is not an identity. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.